Hello again, this is LaZouche Custom here. Okay, well, this is another of my collection videos, just showing you my small collection of various pistols that I've got, mainly 1911 single stacks and Hi-capas, but a couple of other unusual ones thrown in for good measure. Okay, I'll start at the back. I apologise for the shaky videoing, but I'm not using a tripod or anything for this, so you'll have to bear with me. Right, let's start up in this corner here. We have my film collection of pistols, which is in the top, well, the left-hand side there, you can see the commander-sized gun sight pistol that was used by Tom Selleck in the Jesse Stone collection of murder mystery films. That's my replica of it. And the one down the bottom right corner there is, is the Miller Custom pistol used by Magpul's Chris Costa. It was built by Miller Custom for him, and I think it went on to be the sort of design principle behind the Nighthawk Costa pistols that subsequently followed on after it. The one up the top there, that is the Street Kings 1911, which was sort of like my second project that I ever started, which was sort of progressed over the years and has now, well, progressed to the point you see it now, which is pretty much spot on to the real steel. Yeah, it's good film as well, Street Kings. I thoroughly enjoyed it. Even though Keanu Reeves' acting is very wooden, but apart from that, it was a pretty good film. And I love the gun as well. Okay, this one here, another group of sort of film 1911s or whatever, or Hi-capas. This one here is the Marked for Death. Should be a single stack, but unfortunately at the time I didn't have a single stack frame with a square trigger guard available, and I couldn't afford one, so I just went for the Hi-capa version. But this is from the film Marked for Death that Steven Seagal used. It's a compensated Peter Stahl design pistol. There was two of them built for the film, and they're very, very good actually, very, very good. And they've got very large external extractors on them, which are those silver strips you can see near the rear end of the slide. And that's so that they can take multi-calibered rounds or whatever. So yeah, pretty technical pistol then. I think they're also based on the Omega by Springfield Armoury, the Omega pistols, which were pretty good. Okay, these two here, well, yes, it goes without saying. The top one is from the Punisher film, not with the correct grips, I hasten to add. They're my own grips that I made myself, but they just sort of set it off, so they look pretty good. It's getting a bit tattered now, that pistol. I've had it a number of years, so yeah, it might be due for a major overhaul very soon. Now then, the lower one is my AMT 7-inch hardballer, as used by Terminator. Yes, as used by Arnie in Terminator 1. Good pistol, very, very accurate. Out of all of my pistols, it's the most accurate, or seems to be. It hasn't got a tight bore, it hasn't even got a 9-ball hot rubber in it. It's just a standard barrel, standard hot rubber, and it seems to work fine, so yeah, it's pretty good. One thing I will say, going back to the film pistols, which I've sort of another little bit of geeky information, regards the Jesse Stone pistol, the one on the left there, that is actually owned by Tom Selleck. It is his own pistol. He has used it in other programs. The Street Kings 1911, that's actually been used in two TV series. One was The Chase. Don't ask me who starred in it, because I don't know. But it was used in that series, and I think it was used in Undercover Blue or something, which was another cop series. So yeah, just a bit of info there for you. Okay, moving down, I think we will, to this little group here. Top left-hand corner is the Springfield Armoury Range Officer pistol. Good little pistol. Haven't used it an awful lot, but the times I have used it, it's never sort of had any problems, runs perfectly. I'm hopefully going to get some markings done on that as well in the near future. This one here is an old faithful of mine. In fact, it is an old faithful. It's my Wilson Combat KZ9. It's basically an MEU slide mated to a Hi-capa frame. I've customised it quite considerably over the years that I've had it. It's my original Hi-capa frame and all internals, and they are still going. They have not been, well, they've been cleaned, but that's about it. And they are still going. That's standard TM parts, so they've done very, very well indeed. This is one of my newer pistols. This is my Colt gun sight pistol. I've yet to get some markings done on that, which I hope to put in the same time as the Springfield Armoury. Not really had much use of that at all yet. It's still in the sort of just built stage, so hopefully that will be a keeper. This one here is another old faithful. It's changed over the years, a few bits here and there have been added to it. The original tight bore and 9-ball hot rubber have been removed. And the standard parts placed in, but other than that, it's pretty much the same. Good performer, doesn't get used that much. It's just really pretty much not a wall hanger, but it doesn't get used enough really to be classed as a regular pistol. Maybe in the future I might get to use it a bit more. Okay, moving across, we have my Hi-capa collection, which is my top right hand corner, obviously the STI Executive. Very good pistol, full metal kit. I think it was Airsoft, no, Shooter's Design, that's right. Yeah, good kit, quite liked it, apart from the grips, but other than that, it was brilliant and performs exceptionally well. And that's with just a 9-ball hot rubber and a tight ball barrel. And it is very, very good indeed. It's all the other parts are standard, I think. I think the Seer might be an Airsoft Surgeon Seer, but other than that, it's all standard parts and it works perfect. Bottom right hand corner is the Boxer 500 from Enterprise Arms, my custom version of it, or my replica of it. Never hardly gets used, it's mainly a loaner, it gets loaned out to other people, but seems to work pretty good. No one's complained about it malfunctioning or anything. This one here is my another old pistol. This is my Taurus PT-1911. It's been dropped, it's been broken, it's been abused considerably, but it's still going. It's a 1911 A1 slide that's been heavily customised, mated to a Hi-capa frame, with new grips added to it. I think they're Tanya Cobra grips, now made by Garda. And yeah, it's working fine, really, really good. Okay, this little bugger here is my Strayavoit Infinity Masterpiece pistol. It's not a bad little pistol. It's got an exceptionally fast cycling action. As you can see, there are no sights on it. I did fit a red dot sight on it and a mount or whatever, but I've since taken that off purely because it doesn't get used enough. But other than that, it's a very, very accurate little pistol, that when it's set up properly. But as I say, because I've taken the sights off or whatever, I'm considering about doing a trough sight along the very top of the slide like I originally envisaged. I'm still debating whether to do that or not, so that may get changed over the next few months. Okay, moving down to this little group here. Yes, it's my Kimbers. Top left is the Kimber Warrior. It's a full metal pistol now, as you can see. It's had a Hurricane Tactical Entry 2 frame mated to a Nova Warrior slide with a Nova metal outer barrel as well, and it works perfect. No problems with it at all so far. It's a full metal pistol, so it only ever comes out in the summer, because during the winter here in the UK it's too cold for it to work efficiently. But yeah, had no problems with it so far. It works quite well, and the trigger action is very, very nice indeed. It's got a very snappy hammer, and in fact sounds very, very, very realistic as to a real steel. Okay, moving down, we have my old faithful. I've used this quite a bit, even during the winter, which is my Kimber Custom 2 or TLE 2. Good pistol, thoroughly enjoy using it, and yeah, it does get battered about. It's a shooter's design slide, which was originally designed for the Hi-capa, so it's slightly shorter, which means that the barrel pokes out the end a little bit more than it should. But that said, it works lovely. This is a newer little number that I've made. This is my Kimber TLE2 Pro Carry. It's the shorter version of the TLE. Not really used it that much yet, but the times that it has been used, it seems to work okay. So, and that's quite a little simple custom project to do that as well. So whether you're thinking about turning your foliage warrior or desert warrior or whatever into something like that, it's an easy little job to do. Okay, here we have the SIS. This is the Nova version. Originally this kit was built as the Hurricane version. I've since swapped it over in the meantime to this version. Unfortunately, the frame that Nova supply with the kit was badly moulded and the magazine catch didn't fit. I explained all that in a previous video, I believe. So yes, it was a bit of a pain, so it's only got a standard MEU lower plastic TM frame mated to the Nova slide. But that said, it seems to work okay. It's got a standard MEU outer barrel for the moment. I haven't actually got a Nova metal outer barrel to fit to it, so it will stay as it is. But it's not a bad gun, it's pretty good. Okay, here we have my other little group, which is mainly Nighthawk pistols. Okay, first off we have my Lady Hawk, which is a damn good little pistol. Does not hardly ever get used, purely because I'm frightened of damaging it, but it is a good little pistol. It runs pretty good, it's quite accurate, but yeah, I should use that a bit more really. I mean, I've always stated that my pistols will be used and not wall hangers, but I just love the colour of it, and I don't know, I just don't like taking it out that often, but there you are. But then again, I've got so many other pistols to choose from, it is pretty difficult knowing what to use. This is another old pistol of mine. This is my Talon 2 pistol, again a Nighthawk design. This is an old one now. It's been refurbished twice in the past. It's got through three slides. First one was my own fault because the barrel bushing on the end blew out because I didn't machine it enough. The second one, the chin cuts were sort of not in the right place, so I replaced it with a new slide. Again, they're all plastic slides, pretty cheap to replace them. And now it's in the sort of look you see now, so, and it's running pretty good. This one here is my Nighthawk, I'm trying to think of the name of it now. T3, that's it, the compensated T3, because as you can see, it's got a compensator on the front there. At least I hope you can see. It's basically a desert warrior or foliage warrior or whatever, just customised. It's got a custom rear sight on there as well, and a custom foresight mounted on the compensator. It's got the correct grips, they're alien grips, and it's got the correct magwell attached to it as well, which hopefully you can see down there. It's pretty good. I quite enjoy using that pistol. It's got a very snappy slide to it because the actual compensator, as you can see, hopefully, sort of goes up within the slide. It sort of gets sort of taken within the top of the slide there. And yeah, it's very, very good. Very, very snappy slide action to that, and very reliable. Now then, this is one of my later additions. This is my Colt updated Series 70. Updated because it's got a flush mainspring housing, beaver tail grip safety, combat hammer, and an MEU or Novak rear sight. And it's got a custom sight as well that I've made myself for the front. Not hardly used this at all, so it will get used a bit more. It was used originally in its original guise and was loaned out actually for a couple of times. And it's been very, very reliable. I love this designer pistol. The actual finish and everything else on it is fantastic. TM have really done themselves proud on this. So yeah, love that pistol a lot. Okay, moving across to my old faithfuls. Yes, Eleanor at the back there. Both of these are Les Bayer based pistols. The rear one is the Les Bayer Boss. 45 or whatever. It's based on the Premier 2, really, which is their sort of standard pistol. And the lower one is the Monolith. This is where the dust cover, as you can see, has been extended, so it covers it more than what the normal one does. Both pistols are pretty good. The rear one, as you heard me call her, Eleanor, because originally the innards were taken from a 1911 A1 pistol, which was my first single stack TM pistol I ever bought a number of years ago now, in fact quite a few years ago. And she's had thousands of rounds through her, but now, unfortunately, again, due to the fact that I've got so many other pistols to choose from, it hardly ever gets used. The Monolith has been used quite a bit. Had a few issues with that one, don't know why, but they were corrected and she's now working fine. So, yeah, don't know why that was, but there you are. Okay, moving down again, we have the Premier 2, which is this one here. This was the very first MEU I ever bought, and as you can see, customised to look like the Les Baer Premier 2, and it's still going strong. Nothing renewed or updated on it, still got the original hot rubber, the original barrel, all of the innards are original, and it's still going strong. This is my favourite carry pistol. This gets carried in more games than any other, apart from my Kimber TLE 2. And yeah, runs like a Swiss clock. Lovely little gun. It's the Les Baer Thunder Ranch Special. I've yet to put on any markings as yet, but that hopefully the same as my Colt Gunsight Pistol and Springfield Armoury Range Officer in the next few months will hopefully get some markings put on it. Okay, moving across to these two. We have the Ed Brown Jim Wilson Special. This one has remained pretty much unchanged since I made it. It's had no internal upgrades whatsoever. The only thing I have added now is a Series 70 mainspring housing. Originally I made my own, but it wasn't up to the standard that the Series 70 TM ones are, so I swapped it over. This one is the Ed Brown Massad Ayoub Signature Edition. I've since added some transfers or decals, whatever you want to call them, to this, and they seem to work pretty good. It's got a bobtail cut to the frame, which was pretty difficult to do, but I've managed to do it. And I will be doing a few more of those type in the future, so yeah, so stay tuned. Okay, by the way, that one does get used quite a bit, that carry pistol, and it's been very, very reliable so far. So yeah, pretty good, quite happy with that. This is my Desert Eagle, still over nearly a year now. I'm waiting on the chrome parts to turn this into the pistol from barbed wire. It will eventually get done, but when, I don't know. But still going strong, don't hardly ever use it because it's such a big, huge hand cannon. But it will get used, and has been used, but not so often. Okay, right, I'm not going to go to those for a minute. I'm going to go to these ones, or this one. My trusty faithful Glock. Yes, since I bought this, I've used it a fair few times, in fact quite a bit. Always reliable, never had any problems with it, runs like a Swiss clock, considering Glock is Swiss. And yeah, very, very reliable. Bank vault safe with regards to robustness. You can drop it, whatever, it will still carry on working. The Glock 18Cs, which are the full auto ones, do have a weakness at the front of the slide there. They can crack, so I would pay, if you have got an 18C and like to use it on full auto, stick a metal slide on it. The Glock 17, as is, the standard one, is pretty reliable, even with the plastic slide on it. So yeah, pretty good. Okay, this one here, yes, it's the LaZouche Viceroy Custom Pistol. It's my own version, my own one, that I use myself. I haven't used it that often yet, but it's pretty good, good pistol. I did do a limited run of two others for sale. They have since, nearly went to owners, but they haven't gone yet, so, but they will be. Okay, this is my latest project, which I'm currently still working on, as you can see, because it's still in its rough state. It hasn't been sprayed or painted. It's just been dry assembled, i.e. no sort of lubricant or anything inside. It's the Devil Gammon compensated pistol. I've still yet to do the compensated ports on the front of the compensator there. They're still yet to be done. Engravings and stuff, not sure whether I'm going to get those done on this or not. It all depends. The same as the TRS and the Springfield Armoury Range Officer. It all depends, really, whether I can afford it or not. Not used it yet, obviously. It's still, as I say, in the project stage, but it seems to be taking shape pretty good. So I'm quite happy with that. And that's pretty much, guys, is it with regards to my collection. It's grown a fair bit. Actually, I haven't really counted up how many I've actually got here, so we'll go around, shall we? We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32. So we've got 33 pistols in total, plus my Western Arms 6-inch limited, which is up in the loft at the moment. So yeah, quite a few blooming pistols go in there, I've got to admit. Some will most probably be sold, I think, because my collection now is getting ridiculous. I've got to get rid of some of these because, well, to be honest, I just don't use them enough. So I think I shall be selling a few of these off. So who knows, in the future I'll most probably put videos out or whatever saying which ones are going. But as a lot of you guys out there at the moment have not got cash because of this damn blooming, economic crisis, whatever you want to call it, which personally I think is all bank driven, but there you are, it's just to make themselves richer, is going on and on and on. So no one's got any money, but we're always the little guys that suffer. It's the big guys that seem to get richer, but there you are. Anyway, okay, little rant over. So who knows, I might be selling these in the future, we'll just see. It all depends on whether people have got any money to pay for them. Anyway, hopefully you've enjoyed the video and the little brief glimpse into my collection of pistols. There are, what shall I say, obviously future projects to come. Not sure yet, really. We'll just have to see how it goes as to what I'm going to think up next as to do. There are numerous ones out there on my list to do, but it's whether I get the parts or whatever. And now I'm getting quite a few custom orders coming in from viewers and so forth, that it is taking up my time with other work and other projects. So my own projects sort of go on the back burner. They are like hospital jobs now. I just do them in the background compared to customer jobs. Plus the new season for this year, 2013, is starting, so I'll be doing a lot more airsofting hopefully this year. So I doubt I'll have much time for doing my own projects, but that doesn't mean to say that I'm going to stop doing videos. I will never do that. I will keep the videos coming, but they will be more of an instructional type, i.e. detailing how to do stuff, what to do, what parts to fit, and so forth. They won't actually be individual projects. We'll see anyway. We'll see what happens. I am thinking of doing another personal design similar to my Viceroy, but it will be more a carry pistol, although I did classify the Viceroy as a carry pistol, but essentially it's more of a carry target pistol, really. So I am thinking of doing a carry pistol similar to my Colt, but we'll just have to wait and see on that. So because that actual conversion that I've done there is quite reasonable, and with a 9-ball hot rubber and a tight bore barrel, that is a smart, very accurate little pistol. So I may consider doing my own version of that, but we'll see. We'll see how it goes. Anyway, so there you are, guys. Hopefully you've enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching. Thanks very, very much for your patriotism to my channel. I really, really do appreciate it. You guys make it what it is. If it wasn't for you guys asking questions and whatever, then I wouldn't be here, because that's what this channel was originally set up for. So thanks very much for your time and allowing me into your homes every time I do these videos. and passing on my skills and knowledge, as limited as it is, because at the end of the day, pistol smithing and customising of these pistols or whatever is a learning curve, a very steep one. We're always learning, so don't think that because I've been doing this a number of years that I know everything. I don't. But wherever I can, I will try and find out information as best I can and pass it on to you. And that information, as I always state, is for the best or betterment of the accuracy of the pistol, reliability and cost effectiveness, because it is no use spending huge amounts of money on stuff that doesn't work. I've been there, it's very disheartening, and for new airsofters coming into the sport, there is nothing worse than paying out stuff that other people have told you to buy. Oh yeah, yeah, get this, get that. You get it and it's crap. It makes you just want to walk away and just say, sod airsoft, I'm not going to bother with this. It's cost me enough money and nothing's worked. I've been there, friends of mine have been there. It is demoralising, but we've weathered the storm and we've come out the other side with a lot better knowledge. So, as I say, I will try and pass on the best knowledge as possibly as I can. So there you go. Anyway, thanks guys, and as I always say, stay sharp, but stay safe. This is LaZouche Custom saying bye for now.